Obviously, you were paying attention like the rest of us yesterday.
Yes.
Obviously, you, like the rest of us, took note when Michael Cohen basically said in open court, the president directed me to break the law. So I posed the question as I introduced you. What will Congress do about this? Do you think that alone is grounds for impeachment?
So I think that what Congress needs to do right now is we need to make sure that Special Prosecutor Mueller is fully protected from being fired by Donald Trump. Donald Trump has made clear there's only one thing he cares about, and that's protecting his own skin. So he has talked and talked and talked about the special prosecutor. This is obviously a serious ongoing investigation. Mm-hmm. It's already produced more than 24 indictments or guilty pleas. So for me, at this moment, what we ought to be doing over on Capitol Hill, Democrats and Republicans, is passing a law that says the president cannot interfere with that investigation and cannot fire the special prosecutor.
I want to come back to the special prosecutor in just one second, and Robert Mueller here. This was the Southern District of New York, and this is a guilty plea. This is done. Michael Cohen will be sentenced in December. This is done. This isn't about the special counsel anymore in terms of Michael Cohen. This is Michael Cohen saying the president directed me to break a law, directed me to break a campaign finance law. In and of itself, there, is that grounds for impeachment?
The question you're asking is about the president of the United States, and what I'm saying is we have an ongoing investigation that has been in place that is much more sweeping, that is much broader than simply the one thing that happened in New York court yesterday. If you really want to look at what Donald Trump has done and what kind of responsibility he should have, let's get that investigation finished as well. Look at the trial yesterday that yielded 8 convictions. It had multiple counts in it because there were multiple acts of wrongdoing. And this is what prosecutors do all the time.
Yes.
They get all the pieces together and they say, now that I've got all the pieces together, I'm ready to bring charges.
I totally understand that. Insofar as it relates to the president, there are these Justice Department guidelines that a president can't be indicted. So it would ultimately be a political decision about how to deal with the president of the United States. And what I'm hearing from you, Senator, and what I've heard from you in your interviews over the last few months, and you're not alone among Democrats here, is a reluctance to talk about the I word directly. Why would you be nervous to say, hey, I think the House Judiciary Committee should hold hearings and look at this as an impeachable offense?
I'm not nervous. I just want to be effective. And the way that any of us are effective is to say, let's get all of the evidence. Let's get all of the pieces out there. Protect Robert Mueller. Let him finish his investigation. Let him make a full and fair report to all of the American people. And when we've got that, then we can make a decision on what the appropriate next step is.
There's a report in NBC News that there's essentially a Democratic, in case of emergency, break glass plan on what happens if the president does figure out a way to fire Robert Mueller. Is that true, or are you party to that, and what would it be?
Let me put it this way. I think there's no doubt that if the president fires Robert Mueller, he creates a constitutional crisis. And what that means is that we're going to need people on both sides of the aisle to step up and say, no, we are still a nation of laws, and no one in this country, not even the president of the United States, is above the law.
You, this week, perhaps not ironically at all, have proposed sweeping anti-corruption laws, sweeping anti-corruption laws here. Anything in here that would pertain directly to Michael Cohen or Paul Manafort?
Bet. Absolutely. In fact, to both of them. Michael Cohen, one of the things that I propose in this bill is that we put a halt to the kind of influence peddling that Michael Cohen didn't get charged with because it is perfectly legal. That is, if Michael Cohen is going to take more than $500,000 from big companies like AT&T and Novartis, then he has to register as a lobbyist. And once he registers as a lobbyist under my law, every interaction he has with an elected official, that would mean the president of the United States, has to be noted on a calendar, and any pieces of paper or information that he gives them has to be disclosed. One of the consequences of that would be to try to shut down at least another piece of the influence peddling in Washington that has become so routine that big corporations say, oh, somebody new in office, let's figure out how we can spend our bazillion dollars to influence them. No, if people are going to be elected to public office, then by golly, they're supposed to be working in the public interest, not in the interest of people who can pay $500,000 for lobbyists.
I want to ask
over
you,
on the Manafort side, can I just say on that one, my bill says let's take some of the worst parts of lobbying and just make them flatly illegal. Foreign countries and foreign actors should not be able to hire Americans to lobby the United States government. If they want to lobby the United States government, if they want to influence the United States government, use your consul. That's what it's about.
I want to get one last question in here because it is a story, a very important story in the news. It has to do with Molly Tibbetts, the young woman in Iowa who was murdered, her body believed to be found yesterday. A person has been charged with it. This person is an undocumented immigrant. Mike Pence and the president have suggested the immigration laws need to be stronger so that people like this man who was accused of this murder were not in the country. Your reaction?
You know, I'm so sorry for the family here, and I know this is hard, not only for the family, but for the people in her community, the people throughout Iowa. But one of the things we have to remember is we need an immigration system that is effective, that focuses on where real problems are. Last month, I went down to the border, and I saw where children had been taken away from their mothers. I met with those mothers who had been lied to, who didn't know where their children were, who hadn't had a chance to talk to their children, and there was no plan for how they would be reunified with their children. I think we need immigration laws that focus on people who pose a real threat. And I don't think mamas and babies are the place that we should be spending our resources. Separating a mama from a baby does not make this country safer.
Senator Elizabeth Warren from Massachusetts, thanks for being with us this morning.
You bet.